Hi guys, my name is Nishil Kaushal and I am currently interning with the Lexicon company, and today I will talk about attempt to commit suicide. So basically, attempt to commit suicide is presented under section 309 of the Indian Penal Code. It states that whoever attempts to commit suicide and does any act towards the commission of such offence shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year, or fine, or both. So basically, suicide as such is no crime under the code. It is only the attempt to commit suicide that is punishable under this section. In other words, it is only when a person is unsuccessful in committing suicide that the code is attracted. If the person succeeds, there would be no offender who could be brought within the purview of this law. This section is based on the principle that the lives of men are not only valuable to them but also to the states which protects them. The state is under an obligation to prevent persons from taking their lives as it prevents them from taking the lives of others. At common law, although the offender who succeeds in an attempt to suicide was beyond the reach of law, his guilt resulted in the forfeiture of his property. However, attempt to suicide in England has now ceased to be a crime by virtue of Section 1 of the Suicide Act 1961, which states that the rule of law where it is a crime for a person to commit suicide is hereby abrogated. So, the attempt of suicide must be intentional, as the essence of suicide is an intentional self-destruction of life. Thus, if a person takes an overdose of poison by a mistake or in a state of intoxication or in order to evade capture of his pursuers, he is not guilty under this section. Similarly, if a person, because of the family discord, distraction or loss of near or dear relation or other cause like nature overcome the instinct of self-preservation and decides to take his life, he should not be guilty for attempt to suicide. In such case, the unfortunate man deserves indulgence, sympathy and consolation instead of punishment. So a question arises, like, is a hunger strike an attempt to suicide? So basically, hunger strike, which is resorted to at times for getting the demands of strikes fulfilled, possesses the difficulty in this regard. These cases present difficulty in determining whether the intention of the hunger strike is to kill himself or simply to force the authorities to fulfill his demands. If the answer is in affirmative, that for killing himself, then the accused is liable under this section, and if the answer is negative, he does not fall within this purview of Section 309 of the IPC. So due to the impact of globalization, materialism and consumerism is leading to a rise in expectation, and standards of living of people are becoming increasingly depressed and distressed with lesser support structures to prop them up. So basically, the state's power under Section 309 IPC to punish a man for having failed in his attempt to commit suicide is questioned, not only on the grounds of morality, but also on the constitutionality of the said provision. In 1985, Delhi High Court in Sanjay Kumar, while acquitting a young boy who attempted to commit suicide by consuming Tic 20s, strongly advocated for deletion of Section 309 IPC from the statute book and said that the continuance of Section 309 of the Indian Penal Code is an anachronism unworthy of a human society like ours. Instead of sending young boy to a psychiatric clinic, society happily sends him to mingle with criminals. But medical clinics are needed for such misfits, but police and prison never. So basically, suicide was permissible in certain circumstances in ancient India. This is evident from the statement of Manu when he says, a Brahman having got rid of his body by one of those modes, that is drowning, precipitating, burning or starvation, practiced by great sages, is exalted in the world of Brahmana, free from sorrow and fear. This was the society in Asian India. Now, what is Santhara? In Jainism, the tradition of systematic fasting to death is known as Santhara. Santhara is a process that starts after a person takes vow. Santhara has existed since time immemorial in Jainism and is considered to be pious and religious act to liberate the soul from boundaries of karmas. So, should the section 309 be deleted from the Indian Penal Code? As implementation of section 309 IPC to deal with those who attempt to commit suicide is not only unsatisfactory but also discriminatory. A number of eminent social, religious and political leaders have acted contrary to the provisions of section 309 IPC by resorting to strike hunger until death. So basically, what is the difference between a sati and an attempt to suicide? The act of sati, as stated earlier, is not an attempt to suicide. Rather, it is a most barbaric and shameful social evil which demands harsh and deterrent punishment. The punishment should be not accorded to the innocent, illiterate and helpless woman who attempts to commit or become sati, but the punishment should be given to those who perpetuate, glorify and abet a woman to become a sati. Sati and suicide are two different social aberrations. While the former depicts the barbaric attitude and approach of our traditional male-dominated social structure, which compels a widow to take the extreme step of sati, the latter is a product of mental aberration of a helpless, frustrated and mentally sick victim of adverse circumstances. Thank you.